Hi everyone, welcome to this video on how to get started with the Blazor Pager component. The Blazor Pager component splits a dataset into section pages, so you can display them in pages. To explore other features available in our Blazor Pager, please refer to the link in the card above. Now, let's add the Syncfusion Blazor Pager to a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019. Before proceeding, make sure that you have one of the following .NET SDKs installed in your machine. You should also have one of these IDEs installed. With that confirmed, let me start building the app. I open Visual Studio 2019 and create a new project from the project dashboard. From the list of project templates, I choose Blazor WebAssembly app and click Next. Then, I name my project Pager Example and click Next. After that, I continue with the default target framework selected and click Create button to complete the project creation. The project has been created and is ready to use. If you want to know more about Blazor WebAssembly app and how to add Syncfusion components to them, click the video link shown in the YouTube card above. Now let me proceed to add the Blazor Pager component. First, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor Navigations NuGet package in my application. So, I open the NuGet Package Manager by right-clicking the project and choosing Manage NuGet Packages. Then, I search for Syncfusion Blazor Navigations in the Browse tab. I select this package and install it in my project. I click OK to complete the installation. Once the installation is complete, I navigate to the imports.razor file. I add the Syncfusion Blazor Navigations namespace to start using the Blazor Pager in any of the components available in the Pages folder. Next, I open the program.cs file and add the Syncfusion Blazor namespace. Then, I register the Syncfusion Blazor service by calling the method addSyncfusionBlazor within this main method. Next, I need to register a valid license key in my application, so let me register a trial license key using the registerLicense method. To see where to generate this trial key, refer to the link in the description or the card above. Now, I need to define CSS for the Blazor Pager component. For that, I need to install the Syncfusion Blazor themes package in the application. I navigate to the NuGet Package Manager, and in the Browse tab, I search for Syncfusion Blazor themes and install it. Then, I navigate to the index.html file and reference the CSS file from the installed themes package. I add this script reference manually because, by default, the ignore script isolation option is true, and this script reference enables better loading performance for our app. Now, everything is configured, so let me add the Blazor Pager component. In this video, I am going to show you how to display ListView component data items sectioned into pages using the Blazor Pager component. To do this, first, I need to add the Blazor ListView component. So, let me install the Syncfusion Blazor Lists package in my application. I navigate to the NuGet Package Manager, and in the Browse tab, I search for Syncfusion Blazor Lists and install it. Now, I open the imports.razor component and import the namespace Syncfusion Blazor Lists. Then, I navigate to the index.razor component and remove the default content. Within this component, I add the division element with a style attribute and define the Blazor ListView component using the sf_listview tag. I am planning to display product names in the ListView, so first, I add code directive and define a model class, data model, with two fields, ID and name. Then, I create a list view data of type list of data model and assign values to it. I assign this list to the data source property and set the T value to data model to specify the data source type for the list view. The appropriate fields should be mapped for this data source, so I define the list view field settings tag with T value property and map the fields ID to the ID property and name to the text property. I define the show header property as true and header title as products to show the header in the list view component. If you want to know more about the Blazor list view component, check out the video link shown in the card above. Now, I will run this example. You can see in the Blazor ListView component, the product names are listed in a single page. Next, I will show you how to split the ListView data items and display them in pages using the Syncfusion Blazor Pager component. To do this, first, I define a division element with a style attribute and set the max width to 460 pixel inside it. Then, I include the Blazor Pager component using the SF Pager tag and set the total items count property to 25, as the total number of products in the list view data collection is 25. To display 5 products in each page, I define the page size property and set its value to 5. Look at this output page now, the Blazor Pager component rendered below the list view component. Now, I am going to show you how to display appropriate data items in the list view component based on the page number I click. For example, if I click the third page, the data items that ranges from 11 to 15 in the list view component should be displayed. To achieve this, I will add the item click event with an event handler, getPageCount, and define this event handler within this code directive. This event handler receives arguments of type pager item click event args. Next, I am going to calculate the skip value based on the page number I clicked on the pager. So, let me define two variables named skip value and take value of type integer. For this take value, I will assign the value 5, as the initial load of the list view component should fetch first 5 data items from the data source. Here, I need to calculate the skip value, for which I need the current page number and page size information. So, to get the page size, I need to access the pager component instance. For that, let me add a reference to the pager component code and define its instance here. Inside the method, I use the current page number and page size to calculate the skip value and assign the page size to the take value. Next, I need to fetch the appropriate list view data items based on the calculated skip and take value. So, let me add a net directive and create a variable list data and get the appropriate list view data items based on the skip and take value that I pass on these method. Now, I will assign this variable to the data source property of the list view component to display the appropriate data items based on the page number. See the pager component, when you navigate between the pages, the appropriate product names are displayed in the list view component. Also, you can navigate among the pages by clicking the forward or backward navigation indicators. You can also navigate to the last page and first page directly by using these indicators. Next, I will show you how to display a limited number of page numbers in the pager. So, to display limited page numbers, I can use the numeric items count property. I want to display only the first 4 page numbers, so I define the numeric items count property and set its value to 4. Looking at the pager component, only the first 4 page numbers are visible, and the others are replaced by dots. By default, the current page value will be 1, so the products in the first page will be shown in the list view. If I want to display the third page initially, then I define the current page property and set its value to 3. See the pager component now, the third page is displayed initially, and the appropriate products are listed in the list view component. By default, the pager message will show in the right corner of the component to display information about the total number of data items and pages. If I want to hide this message, I can define the show pager message property and set its value to false. When you look at the page component now, the message is hidden. In this video, we saw how to create a Blazor WebAssembly app using Visual Studio 2019 and add a Syncfusion Blazor Pager component to it. We discussed how to split ListView component data items and display them in pages. We also saw how to hide the pager message, change the current page value, and display limited page numbers. If you would like to see the working code of this example, you can download it from the GitHub link in the description below. I have also provided a link where you can see if you qualify for a free community license to use all our Blazor products. If you found this video useful, don't forget to click the like button and subscribe to our channel to watch more videos like this. Thanks for watching.